여러분, 제임스 기어리를 큰 박수로 맞이해 주시기 바랍니다.
Please welcome Mr. James Geary with a big hand.
굿 애프터눈. It's a pleasure to be here with you this afternoon, and I would like to thank the organizers of the Seoul Digital Forum for inviting the Nieman Foundation for Journalism at Harvard to collaborate on this special session. This afternoon, the theme of our session is the evolution of storytelling, specifically how journalists are using new technologies and new platforms to push creative boundaries while also maintaining the highest journalistic and ethical standards. But to talk about the latest innovations in storytelling, I would like to begin by talking about a much, much older form of storytelling. In fact, a form of storytelling that most of the people in this room right now know much more than I do about, because you probably learned about it in high school. I'm referring to shijo, which is the unique Korean poetic form that began almost 700 years ago in the 14th century. As you all know, shijo poems written in the shijo form have a very, very specific structure. They each have three lines, and each line has a very specific number of syllables, and each line in the poem serves a very specific purpose. The first line in a shijo sets out the theme, what the poem is about. The second line elaborates on that theme and develops it a little bit. And the third line contains a kind of a twist or a turn that makes the poem pivot to a memorable and often surprising conclusion. Now, one of the most famous shijo, and my personal favorite, was written by a man named Yang Saon, who was a government official and an avid mountain climber. I'd like to invite Professor Kang Yong-chol, who's a professor of media at Sukmyung University, to come on stage and read this shijo.
태산이 높다 하되 하늘 아래 메이로다. 오르고 또 오르면 못 오르리 없건만은 사람이 제 안이 오르고 매만 높다 하더라.
Thank you, Professor Kang. Now I'd like to read the English translation. Men may say the mountain's high, but all of it's beneath the sky. There's no reason we can't climb to the top if we so decide. But usually we never try. We only say the mountain's high. Now, one of the reasons I'm so fascinated by shijo, apart from the beauty of the poetry itself, is that the structure of a shijo is identical to the structure of a traditional American journalistic feature story. A feature story begins with a lead, which is a description of a scene or some other kind of description that lays out the theme of the piece, and this corresponds to the first line of a shijo. And it's called the lead because it's the first thing in the article. The lead is followed by what we in America call the nut graph, which elaborates the theme and embellishes the theme. And we call it a nut graph because it contains the core of the article, the core of the kernel of the meaning of the article. And after the nut graph, at the very end of the article, comes the kicker. And the kicker sums up the article and often moves, just like the third line of a shijo, to a surprising and memorable conclusion. And we call it a kicker for that very reason, because it gives the audience a little jolt. Now, if you analyze my introduction to this session later, you'll see that I'm using the shijo structure. My lead was talking about the shijo that Professor Kang read, and my nut graph was comparing the shijo to an American, traditional American journalistic feature, and you're just going to have to wait a few minutes to find out what my kicker is. So today, as storytelling continues to evolve, traditional structures of journalism, like the feature article, are being challenged and transformed in exciting and creative ways. And we are fortunate to have with us this afternoon journalists who are at the forefront of this change. The goal of every feature is to immerse the reader in an experience, to show them the world from someone else's point of view. And thanks to virtual reality, this is possible in dramatically new and creative ways. Yulia Parshina-Kotas, a graphics and multimedia editor at the New York Times, will shortly talk about some of the work that the newspaper is doing to use virtual reality to enhance its storytelling. Social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, and Snapchat, with their emphasis on brevity and short bits of information, also challenge traditional journalistic forms, which typically run to thousands of words and not 140 characters, as in a tweet. But Neil Shea, a contributing writer at National Geographic magazine, is using Instagram to tell longer features, to immerse readers in stories that they might not experience in a traditional magazine format. Now, in the past, typically, audience interacted with journalism only after it was published. But now, audiences are interacting with journalism as it's made, and often they're contributing to the creation of the journalism. Andrew Metz, a managing editor at Frontline, is going to show us some of the investigative documentaries that they've been doing, experimenting with virtual reality and also interactivity to enhance the impact of their investigative work. The rapid pace and dramatic nature of storytelling's evolution raises important questions for all of us. What journalistic and ethical values will guide our use of these technologies? What is the role of the professional journalist today, when everyone in this room and many, many people around the world have the most powerful storytelling tool right in their pockets, a smartphone? What do the traditional values of fact-based reporting, can they survive in an age when so much of the media environment is dictated by opinion? And finally, when it's so easy to manipulate and alter someone's reality just by changing a few pixels in a computer, what role, what responsibility do journalists and non-journalists have to the truth? Professor Kong, who read the poem earlier, will also be part of our panel to help us address some of these questions. So Yulia and Neil and Andrew will give brief presentations, then we'll all regroup on the stage for a panel discussion. The challenges facing journalism today, they're economic, they're demographic, they're technological, and they're very, very high indeed. But as Yang San wrote in his Sijo, all of them are still beneath the sky. With innovative storytellers like the individuals you're about to meet soon, who are exploring compelling new ways to engage and inform audience through journalism, there is no reason we can't rise to meet these challenges. So let us not say the mountain is high. Let us climb. Thank you.
네.